Undergrad? Grad school? What's the diff? Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in. I'll start by saying that I'm a marine biologist, and I did both my undergraduate and graduate work in the United States. So my answer to this question has sort of a biology and US-centric twist on it. But I think graduate school around the world is consistent enough, especially in the sciences, that my answers to this should be fairly ubiquitous across the world. I'm sure a lot of graduate students at some point, I know I did, had conversations with their friends and family that went something like this. Hey Joe, how's it going? Oh, not too much, just in grad school studying biology. Weren't you doing that the last time I saw you, like 5 years ago? Oh yeah, that was my master's, but now I'm doing my PhD. Geez, really? How long does that take? Oh, a few more years. Man, you must love school. I think most graduate students have probably had that conversation with friends and family somewhere along the line. The reality is that most people have a pretty good grasp of what undergrad is like. You go to orientation, and your major advisor tells you what classes to take over the next 4 years. You take those classes, you get a syllabus that at the beginning of the semester that tells you when the exams are, when projects are due, when classes are, and then you take exams and you get a grade that's supposed to summarize whether you learned what they told you to learn. Well, graduate school is really not like that at all. The whole grades, classes, and GPA thing is really not that important. In grad school, you're trying to learn how to become a scientist. You're trying to learn how to do research. And the way you do that is kind of like that Netflix show Westworld. Yeah, sort of like a combination of Wild Wild West and a choose your own adventure game. Basically, the decisions you make along the way will dictate your successes and failures. And it even starts before you even start graduate school. You get to decide, you have the freedom to decide where you go and who you work with. You sort of sit back and think, you know, who would I like to work with? What kind of research questions am I interested in? Do I want to study fish behavior on a coral reef, or do I want to study crab genetics in a lab? The decisions are up to you. You have the freedom to decide which path to take. And then once you start graduate school, your day-to-day activities, your day-to-day objectives are totally up to you. So the decisions you make each day will decide whether you learn what you need to learn, whether you pursue a certain path of research. They decide whether you have a good day or a bad day. And some of your decisions will be good, but not the best. Some of them will sort of be minor diversions. Some of them you'll think, oh my God, this is perfect. I made the right decision. I'm gonna study this. This is my destiny, yes. And then it ends in a total failure. So in grad school, you really learn how to own both your successes and your failures because you made those decisions. You were the one who decided what to do with your time. You were the one who decided what path to take. You have to learn how to think because there ain't nobody around telling you what to learn. So grad school is very different than undergrad because nobody's holding your hand along the way. Right, Joe. But when are you gonna stop delaying adulthood and get a real job? This is another pretty common sentiment that graduate students feel when they're in graduate school. Yes, we're called students, and yes, we're in school, and no, we don't have a boss or a timesheet or paid sick leave or something like that. But graduate school should be considered a bona fide job, or at least it should be treated that way. One of the situations that I remember most about starting grad school that made me think this is a real job was when they gave me office space and a desk and a mailbox in the mailroom. That was a pretty jobby surprise when I started grad school. But really the jobbiest thing about going to grad school is the time commitment. In undergrad, you're kind of used to, you have weekends off, maybe you have nights off, maybe you have vacations off. If there are events that cause classes to be canceled, like hurricanes or pandemics, you get that time off. If you think that graduate school is like undergrad in that way, not so fast. In grad school, you work all year round. Weekends, holidays, summers, those are actually some of the best times to get your work done. During the semester, you're often a little too busy with classes and teaching and lab meetings that you don't have a whole lot of time to do that much needed work, especially writing. So as far as real jobs go, grad school is not a Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, spring break, beach party kind of thing. It's an all the time kind of thing. Yes, graduate school should be treated like a job, but not just because of the time commitment in your own personal life, but because the work you do in graduate school is actually contributing to society. As an undergrad, you're mostly consuming knowledge and experiences. And in grad school, you're definitely doing that too, but you're also a living, breathing part of the scientific community. You know those people that are pushing the boundaries of science and innovation so that we all can live happier, healthier, more harmonious lives? Yeah, those guys and gals. In grad school, you're publishing original research articles. You're giving scientific presentations at conferences. You're competing for scientific grants. You're doing all the things that a professional scientist does, including teaching the next generation of doctors and pharmacists and dentists and veterinarians through the classes that you teach. The last difference I'll point out between undergraduate school and graduate school has to do with money. In the United States, you frequently pay tuition to go to undergraduate school, and you also pay tuition to go to med school, law school, business school. But here's one of the best kept secrets about graduate school and science. You frequently get paid.
Say what?
Yes, it's true. Graduate students in biology and other sciences frequently get paid to go to graduate school. This usually covers your stipend, your living expenses, your tuition, as well as sometimes healthcare. So whether it's a teaching assistantship provided by the department, or a fellowship awarded to you, or perhaps a grant that your advisor received that then pays your salary, these colleges and universities don't expect graduate students to take out big fat student loans to cover their living expenses and tuition while they're in grad school. So you get paid, don't worry, it's not that much, but it's enough to survive, and it's enough to keep you from having to take out student loans or get a second job while you're in grad school. So, unlike the undergrad experience that so many people are familiar with, grad school is a full-time, wild, wild west adventure game in which you get paid just above the minimum wage to contribute to society and the future of our existence on this planet. Yeah, I guess that sounds pretty different.
Hey everyone, if you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also like us on Facebook, and you can check out some more videos on this channel, also on our website, SciAll.org. Thanks.